السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. In last class, we learned lesson 9, section A. Alif means section A. Ba, section B. In section A, we have learned Naat and Manut. What is Naat and what is Manut? Correct? Naat. And Manut. Right? Naat, Manut is, for example, this is a new house. So the new will be Naat and house will be Manut. Alright? In Arabic, the adjective will be second and the noun which we are giving adjective will be come first. Okay? Hada Baitun. Baitun Jadidun. Jadidun. This is a new house, right? Jadidun is new. In English, the adjective will come first and the noun will come second. But in Arabic, the noun will come first and then the adjective will come next. So the adjective will be called as Naat in Arabic. The noun is Manut. Jadidun is Naatun. Baitun is Manut. Okay. We also learned that the Naat and Manut should be match in four things. One is being Nakira and Marifa, right? Being Alif Lam, Nakira and Marifa. If Naat doesn't have Alif Lam, then Man'ut also, sorry, if Man'ut doesn't have Alif Lam, that means the second part, Naat shouldn't be having the Alif Lam. The other way, if the Man'ut contains the Alif Lam, then Naat should contain Alif Lam. Secondly, gender. Secondly, gender. If first one is male, then the second one also should be masculine related word. If the first word, which is Man'ut in Arabic, is feminine, then the Naats should be follow the same gender. Third one is Haraka, correct? We say case. A case means Haraka. Huh? That means if Baitun is Dhammatain, then Jadidun also should be Dhammatain. If Baitan, then Jadidan. Baitin, Jadidin. Baiti Jadidi. So exactly Haraka will follow the first one. The second will follow the first one. The fourth one is count. But so far we are looking at the single count. So we may not understand what is how it will differ. Okay. So just understand that there are four things where the first noun and the second noun should match. Okay. This is what we have learned in lesson 9, section A. Section A, we learned Man'ut, Naat, both are Nakira, right? All the examples we have seen, both words are Nakira without Alif Lam. Without Alif Lam. Correct? But in this section B, we are going to see with alif lam. That means if the first one contains alif lam, that means the second one also should contain alif lam. Section B, we will see more examples with alif lam. Okay. Ba. Aynal mudarrisu. Where is the teacher? Where is the teacher? Huwa fil fasli. Huwa fil fasli. He is in the classroom. Fasl means classroom. Wa aynal mudarrisul jadidu. You see here. Wa aynal mudarrisul jadidu. In section A, all the examples are nakira. Okay. In section B, we are looking at some example which has alif lam. That means both are ma'rifah. Wa aynal mudarrisul jadidu. Where is the new teacher? Where is the new teacher? The teacher contains alif lam. So the naat should contain alif lam. Wa aynal mudarrisul jadidu. And you see haraka also same. And then gender feminine, it will come like this, correct? But here both are masculine. Wa aynal mudarrisul jadidu. Where is the new teacher? Huwa indal mudiri. Huwa indal mudiri. Inda also consider a dharf. Mudiri is mudafun ilayhi, adverb. Naat means adjective. Dharf means dharfun. Dharfun means adverb. So the noun followed by the adverb will take kasra because it will be a mudafun ilayhi. Huwa indal mudiri. He is with the principal. With the principal. Aina talibul jadidu. Where is the new student? Again, you see new student. We are giving a adjective. The adjective can be anything. Is a like new, ugly, or beautiful. Whatever we are giving a describing the noun, it will be a naat. Okay. Aynal talibul jadidu. Where is the new student? Alif lam. So naat should also contains alif lam. Aynal talibul jadidu. First one done. Gender masculine, masculine. Second condition correct. Case haraka, dhamma, dhamma. Correct. Count, this is also single, single. Okay. Dhahaba ilal maktabati. Previously we have learned maktab without ta, correct? Maktabun we have learned. Maktabun means what? Table. Maktabun. Maktabun means table. We have learned. But maktabatun means, it's not female table. It is a library. Maktabatun means, don't say female table. There is no female table. It's a library. Where we keep all the books. Maktabun is table. Maktabatun means library. Okay. New word which we are learning in this lesson. Dhahaba ilal maktabati. Aina talibul jadidu. Where is the new student? Dhahaba ilal maktabati. He went to the library. Then next, man dhalika rajulu tawilu, tall man. So we are describing the man with tallness, right? So tall is the naat adjective. So whenever we found naat manwut, we have to make sure these four are matching in both. Here also al. Gender, masculine. Case, dhamma. Count, single. Okay. Man dhalika rajulu tawilu, who is that tall man? Alladhi means alladhi, a new word again. Maktaba, new word. Inda, new word. Alladhi is, for example, right? We say in English, right? This is the man who came yesterday, okay? This is the ball which I bought yesterday, okay? Which is new. Anything which I bought yesterday. Here, who, which, what is this? Actually, it's a relative pronoun. We are saying that this ball, this man. So there is a two sentence. We are relating two sentences into one. In English, we are using who, which, right? In Arabic, we say alladhi. Man dhalika rajulu tawilu alladhi kharajal anu minal madrasati. Who is man? Who is that? Tall man. Rajulu tawilu. Tall man. Alladhi. Who? Kharajal an minal madrasati. Exited now from the school. Minal madrasati. From the school. Min is harful jar. So we have to give kasra. Minal madrasati. An means now. Now. Exited now. So alladhi is a who, which, not a question. I hope you can understand. The who and which is not a question word here. It's a connective and relative. For rational, we use who. Irrational things, we use which. Same in Arabic. Okay. Man dhalika rajulu tawilu. Who is that tall man? Alladhi. Who exited now, went out now from the school. Minal madrasati. Man dhalika rajulu tawilu. Alladhi kharajal ana minal madrasati. Who is that tall man who went out now from the school? Who is that man? Huwal mudirul jadidu. Huwal mudirul jadidu. The answer is, he is new principal. We can say headmaster or manager also. We can say mudir is a lead of the working place. So in school, headmaster. College is principal. Office is a manager. Okay. So if we are talking about school, then we can say is a headmaster. If we are talking about a college, we can say principal. So head of the working place. Huwa al-mudirul jadidu, new principal. Huwa al-mudirul jadidu, new principal. So principal is man'ud, jadidu is na'ad. adjective. So we have to see, it should match four things. Alif Lam, Alif Lam. Done. First is correct. Then gender, masculine, masculine. All right. Haraka, Dhamma, Dhamma. Third is correct. Count. This is singular. This is also singular. Okay. If it comes as a plural, right, then this one also should have plural verb. Okay. Huwal mudirul jadidu. He is new principal. Then the next one. Wamanil waladu saghiru. Who is the small boy? So boy, we are describing with smallness. So it's an adjective. Naat. Manot. Again, the four things should match. Wamanil waladu saghiru. Who is that small boy? Alladhi. Who went out from the classroom. Fasal means classroom. Went out now from the classroom. Who is the small boy who, this who is different, this who is different. Man also who, we will translate as a who. Alladhi also who. But this is integration word. This is not a integration word. Integration is not a question word. Who is that small boy who went out now from the classroom? Huwa ibnul mudirul jadidu. This is a hamzatul wasl. So we have to skip it and join the verb with b. Huwa ibn. If there is no huwa, if it comes first word of the sentence, then we can say ibnul mudiri. Huwa ibnul mudiril jadidi. You see here? The first noun, mudirul jadidu. Mudirul jadidu. New principal. Here, dhamma. So, this nat also takes dhamma. But in this line, sentence, huwa ibnul mudiri. Principal's son. So, principal's is mudafun ilayhi. So it takes kasra, right? Then this nat also follow the man'ut. Follow the man'ut and take kasra. So huwa mubtada, ibnu khabar wa mudafun, al mudiri mudafun ilayhi wa man'utun. This is nat. Nat adjective. Naad, manut, naad. Four things we have to match. Alif lam, alif lam. Gender, masculine, masculine. If feminine, it will be mudira. Okay, correct? Mudira means feminine. Then jadida. Mudiratul jadidatu means female principal. Mudiratul jadidatu. If we bring mudiratun here, then jadidatun. If we say jadidun, it will be wrong. It's not correct. Grammatically, it is wrong. If mudiratu, then the naat should be jadidatun. Jadidatu. Gender, masculine, masculine. Alif lam, gender. Haraka, you see, man'ut takes kasra, so the naat will just follow the manut in the four things. Kasra. Count, singular, singular. Huwa ibnul mudiril jadidi. He is new principal's son. Ibnu means son. He is new principal's son. What is the question? Wa manil waladu saghiru. Who is that small? Saghiru, small. Who is that small boy? Who? Alladhi. Who? Kharajal ana minal fasli. Went out now from the classroom. Huwa ibnul mudiril jadidi. He is new principal's son. Okay, then next. Liman. Li belong to or belongs to, right? Li. Liman means belongs to who? We already learned this, right? Liman. Don't read as Lamin. This is Liman. Liman. Liman tilka sayyaratul jadidato. You see here, feminine. Then, Nat should also should be feminine word. Liman tilka sayyaratul jamilato. Whose is that? Dalika is masculine, that. Feminine is tilka, that. Liman tilka sayyaratul jamilatu. Jamilatu, beautiful. Whose is that beautiful car? Whose is that beautiful car? Here, sayyaratu, beautiful car. We are describing a sayyara with beautifulness. So, man'ut, na'at. Again, it should match four things. Alif lam, alif lam. Gender, here is feminine. Sayyaratu is feminine. So, jamilatu also feminine. Third, haraka. Dhamma, dhamma. Fourth, count. Singular, singular. Liman tilka sayyaratul jamilatu. Whose is that beautiful car? Yalil mudiril jadidi. Li is belongs to or to, right? Li is harful jar. So, mudir got majroor. Jadidi is adjective, na'ad. So, it will follow the man'ut in all the four things. Okay. Hiya lil mudiril jadidi. It is, belongs to new principal. Describing a principal with a word new. New principal. It is belongs to the new principal. Four things. Okay. Li, look at this word. It's supposed to be Li Al-Mudiri. Okay. I will try it. Li al-mudiril jadidi. Jadidi. Here we can put as here. Here Li al-mudiril jadidi. It's supposed to be okay. Here Li Al Mudiril Jadidi. But when Li followed by Alif Lam, right, then the Alif will be omitted. Alif will be omitted. Be Li Li. Lil Mudiri. We read as Mudiri. Read and write both. We will skip the Alif. If the Li is followed by Alif Lam, then we will skip the Alif. Okay? That's why here Alif is omitted. Why it is omitted? Is because if Li is followed by Alif Lam, then we will omit the Alif in written and verbal in both. So Don't say this is Alif Lam. Here don't have Alif Lam. Yes, it has Li Al Mudiri. By right, it's supposed to be Li Al Mudiri. So Alif Lam, Alif Lam. Then second one, gender, masculine, masculine. Here feminine, feminine. Third one is Haraka. Here is Majroor because of Li. Li is Harful Jar. Kasra, so the Nat is exactly following the same Haraka, Kasra. Then count, singular, singular. Here Lil Mudir Al Jadidi. Liman Tilka Sayyaratul Jamilatu. Whose is that beautiful car? Here Lil Mudir Al Jadidi. It is belongs to new principal. Next. Liman Hadal Kitabul Kabiru. Liman Hadal Kitabul Kabiru. Liman whose? Belongs to who? That means whose. Hadal Kitabu. Hada this. Kabiru is big. Book. Kitabu is book. Liman Hadal Kitabul Kabiru. Whose is this big book? Ahua Lil Mudarrisi. Is it belongs to the teacher? Again, this is supposed to be Li Al Mudiri. When Li followed by Alif Lam, then we will omit Alif. Similarly, Alhamdulillah, right? Alhamdulillahi. You see, Allah will be omitted. Allah, Alif will be omitted in Allah. If you write Allah, how do you write? Like this, right? But you see, Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah. Lilla, there will be no alif. Why? It's because of the same rule. If li followed by alif, alif will be omitted in written and verbal. So it become lilla. Liman hadal kitabul ahwa lil mudarrisi. Whose is that big book? Is it whose is this? Hada means this. Whose is this big book? Ahwa lil mudarrisi. Is it belongs to the teacher? La, no. Huwa litwalibil jadidi. Huwa litwalibil jadidi. Talib means student. No, it is belongs to. Littwalibil jadidi belongs to a new student. Again, new student is adjective. We are describing the student with a newness. All right. So again, we have to make sure it is matching for Alif Lam, Alif Lam. Masculine, masculine. Kasra, kasra. Count, singular, singular. Liman hadal kitabul kabiru ahwa lil mudarrisi. Whose is this big book? Is it belongs to the teacher? La huwa litwalibil jadidi. No, it is belongs to the new student. And then next. Aynal mil'aqatu. Aynal mil'aqatu saghiratu. Mil'aqa means spoon. Correct? Mil'aqa means spoon. Saghiratu, small. Saghirun also small. Saghiratun feminine form. Why? Mil'aqatun is feminine. So saghirun become a feminine form. Saghiratun. Aynal mil'aqatu saghiratu. Where is the small spoon? Here fil kubi. Kub means cup. Huwa fil kubi. It is in the cup. Kubi. Because fi is harful jar. So ismul majrur will take kasra. Aynal mil'aqatu saghiratu? Aynal mil'aqatu saghiratu? Where is the small spoon? Here fil kubi. It is in the cup. Aynal kursiyul maksuru? Aynal kursiyul maksuru? Aina, where is the chair? Kursiyu, chair. Al maksuru, broken. Where is the broken chair? So we are describing the chair with brokenness, right? Broken. Manut, naat. Broken chair. What type of chair? It's a broken chair. Where is the broken chair? Huwa hunaka. Hunaka means there. It is there. It is there. Huwa hunaka. It is there. Ainal kursiyul maksuru. Where is the broken chair? Again, four things. Alif lam, alif lam. Masculine, masculine. Dhamma, dhamma. Number four, singular, singular. So, one, two, three, again, four is also singular. Huwa hunaka, it is there. Hai, tamari. Before we go to the exercise, we will read the lesson one more time. Maybe this round together, we will read it together. Okay, always when you when we read, read loudly. Every time I will remind this word. Read loudly. Don't read within your mouth. Okay. Since Ustad cannot listen, cannot see, so never mind. Let him keep saying. We will keep doing what we do. Don't do that like that, okay? Read loudly. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم با أين المدرس Where is the teacher هو في الفصل He is in the classroom وأين المدرس الجديد وأين المدرس الجديد Where is the new teacher هو عند المدير He is with The principal. Inda is larf. That's why mudiri is mudafun ilayhi. It takes kasra. Aina talibul jadidu. Aina talibul jadidu. Where is the new student? Zahaba ilal maktabati. Zahaba ilal maktabati. Went to the library. من ذلك الرجل الطويل الذي خرج الآن من المدرسة من ذلك الرجل الطويل الذي خرج الآن من المدرسة Alif is Hamzat al-Wasl. So when you read jointly write lulladhi, not lu alladhi, lulladhi. Man ذلك الرجل الطويل الذي خرج الآن من المدرسة. Who is that tall man who went out now from the school? هو المدير الجديد. هو المدير الجديد. He is the new principal. ومن الولد الصغير الذي خرج الآن من الفصل ومن الولد الصغير الذي خرج الآن من الفصل ومن الولد الصغير الذي خرج الآن من الفصل and who is that small boy who exit or went out now from the classroom. Huwa ibnul mudiril jadidi. Huwa ibnul mudiril jadidi. He is new principal's son. Liman tilkas sayyaratul jamilatu? Liman tilkas sayyaratul jamilatu? Whose is that beautiful car? Hiya lil mudiril jadidi. Hiya lil mudiril jadidi. It is belongs to the new teacher, new principal. Liman hadhal kitabul kabiru? Ahuwa lil mudarrisi? Liman hadhal kitabul kabiru? Ahuwa lil mudarrisi? Whose is this big book? Is it belongs to the teacher? La, no. Huwa litwalibil jadidi. Huwa litwalibil jadidi. It is belongs to the new student. Aynal milaqatu saghiratu? Aynal milaqatu saghiratu? Where is the small spoon? Huwa fil kubi. It is in the cup. It is in the cup. Why here? Because milaqatu is feminine, so we are using here. Kursiyu is masculine, so we are using huwa. But meaning is, this is also it, this is also it. Because we are pointing to, we are using this to irrational thing. If rational thing, we will say, this is he, this is she. Hiya fil kubi. It is in the cup. Aynal kursiyul maksuru. Aynal kursiyul maksuru. Where is the broken chair? Where is the broken chair? Huwa hunaka. Huwa hunaka. It is there. It is there. Khair. Tamarin exercise. Yaqra waktu. Read and write. Read and write. Okay. Read and write. Iqra waktub. At-tabibul jadidu fil mustashfa. At-tabibul jadidu fil mustashfa. والطبيب القديم في المستوصف. I read one more time. الطبيب الجديد, the new doctor is في المستشفى, in the hospital. اسم المقصور, we have learned right. So we say, although this is مجرور, في is حرف الجر, we don't give كسرة because it's a Ismul Maqsoor. Ismul Maqsoor means the last letter will be Alif and the previous letter should take Fa. Although it's written as a Ya, we will read it as Alif. Mustasfa. So this noun is called as Ismul Maqsoor. At-tabibul jadidu fil mustashfa. The new doctor is in the hospital. Wat-tabibul qadim. Qadim is old. The old doctor is fil mustausaf. Mustausaf is clinic, small hospital. Mustashfa is a hospital. Mustausaf means clinic, small hospital. The new doctor is in the hospital. The old doctor is in the clinic. Second, al qalamul maksuru ala al maktabi. Al-qalamul maksuru alal maktabi. The broken pen. Man'ud, na'ad. So we have to follow exactly all the four things we have learned, right? Four items we have to follow the previous noun. Al-qalamul maksuru alal maktabi. The broken pen is on the table. Maktab. Maktaba means library. Maktab table. Maktabatun is a library. Al-qalamul maksuru ala al-maktabi. The broken pen is on the table. The next is a new word. Al-mirwahatu means fan. We have fan, right? Al-mirwahatu. The fan, the new fan, jadidatu. Why jadidatu? Mirwahatu is feminine. So jadidun, we bring here, you see, jadidu. Why? This is masculine. So this comes as a masculine form. Here, mirwahatu is feminine form. So jadidatu, it comes with feminine form. Al-mirwahatu jadidatu, the new fan is fil ghurfatil kabirati. Fil ghurfatil kabirati. And, the new fan is in the big room. Kabirati is big room. These two is man'ut na'at, and these two also man'ut na'at. Al-birwahatul jadidatu fil ghurfatil kabirati. The new fan is in the big room. Number four. Al-lughatul arabiyyatu sahlatun. Al-lughatul arabiyyatu. The Arabic language is. What language? Arabic language. So we are describing language with Arabic. So this is man'ut na'at. Al-lughatul arabiyyatu sahlatun. So these two words should follow the four condition. Al-lughatul arabiyyatu sahlatun. Sahlatun is easy. Arabic language is easy. Fifth one. Al-waladu tawilu. Al-waladu tawilu. The tall boy is. Tawil means tall. Tawil, tall. Waladu, boy. The tall boy is who? Alladhi, who? Kharaja minal fasli al-an. Kharaja went out. Minal fasli, from the classroom. On, now. Al-waladu tawilu alladhi kharaja minal fasli al-an. The tall boy who went out from the classroom just now is Talibun min al-Kuwait. So this is the khabar. I have told where you can put the is, the next letter will be khabar. So this is Mubtada, Man'ut, Tawil is Nat. This one we will say Ismul Mausula. We can learn later the tarkib for this. But this is the khabar. Why? You can put the is here. The tall boy who exited, went out from the classroom just now is Talibun, student. Is a student from Minal Kuwaiti. Kuwait, we know, right? Iran, Iraq, Kuwait, that country. Kuwait. The country name. Al-waladu tawilu alladhi kharaja min al-fasli al-an talibun min al-Kuwaiti. The tall boy who went out from the classroom now is a student from Kuwait. Okay. Next. Ana fil madrasati sanawiyyati. Ana, I am. Ana means I am. Fil, in, al-madrasa, school. Which school? Athanaviyya, secondary school. So we are describing a school with thanaviyya. Naat, adjective. This is manod. Okay? Thanaviyya means secondary school. Secondary, okay? Secondary. Thanaviyya. Ibtidaiya, primary school. Ibtidaiya. We say ibtidaiya. Mubtada, right? Ibtada. Ibtidaiya. Ibtidaiya means primary school, starting school, primary school. Thanaviya, secondary school. Thani, Thani is two, right? Thanaviya means secondary school. Ana fil madrasati thanaviyati. Man'ut, na'at. So both should match with four conditions. I am in the secondary school. Next. Dhahaba ar-rajulul faqiru ila al-waziri. Faqir, poor. Wazir, minister. Okay. Poor, minister. Sorry. Minister. Okay. Dhahaba went. The poor man. We are describing man with poorness, correct? Poor man. Manut, naat. Then, ila means to. Ilal waziri, harful jar. So we have to give waziri. The poor man went to the minister. Next. Jalasa talibul jadidu. Jalasa talibul jadidu. New students, jalasa, sat. We learned, right? Sat. Sit, sat. Khalfa hamidin. Behind the hamid. Khalfa is dharfun. Dharfun. Adverb. Hamidin mudafun ilayhi. So we have to give hamidin. Jalasa talibul jadidu, the new students sat behind the hamid. Next. As-sikinul kabiru, big knife. Knife. Okay. As-sikinul kabiru, big knife. Hadun jiddan, short, very short. The big knife is very short. The big knife is very sharp. Then, man hadal waladul qasiru. Qasiru means tawilu, tall. We have seen just before, right? Tawilun. Tawilun means tall. Tawilun, tall. Qasir means short. Man hadal waladul qasiru. Who is this short boy? Man, who, hada, this, al-waladul qasiru, short boy, man'ut, na'ad, adjective. Who is this short boy? Huwa ibnul mudarrisil jadidi. Huwa ibnul mudarrisil jadidi. He is new teacher's son. New teacher's, adjective, man'ut, na'ad. He is new teacher's son. Okay, next, second exercise. Imla fil faraghi. Farag means blank. Imla fill in the blank. Fima yali, in the following. Fima yali means in the followings. What you have to, asikinu is knife. Sikino means knife. Imla fil faragi fima yali. Fill in the blank in the following sentences. Bin na'atil ladhi bainal qawsaini. Bin na'at. Na'at. Na'at means adjective. We have to fill the adjective here. Which na'at? Alladhi bainal qawsaini. Which is given in the qawsain means bracket. Qawsaini means bracket. Baina qawsaini na between. Baina between. Baina between. Qawsaini between the brackets. Ba'da tahliyatihi bi al in the luzumi. After considering putting the alif lam when it is mandatory in the luzumi. In the luzumi means with mandatory. That means what they are saying is man'ut is given here, na'at is given here. You have to make sure where this na'at should contain alif lam and where should not contain alif lam. Where should contain alif lam, where should not contain alif lam. For example, come here, aynal mudarrisu jadidu. This is the adjective we are going to give to the teacher. Aynal mudarrisu, where is the new teacher? Can we write jadidu as it is in the bracket? Cannot. Why? Four things we have to match. If man'ud, first thing is if alif lam, then this one also should have alif lam, correct? And this is what they are asking you to do. Before putting the adjective in the blank space, make sure whether this adjective should take alif lam or not. Aynal mudarrisul jadidu? Where is the new teacher? Adjective should have alif lam. Then followed by whatever you have, you put it here. Come here. At-tajiru. At-tajiru. Merchant. Kabiru. Big merchant. Fis-suki. In the market. Suk means market. In fis-suki. Okay. At-tajiru kabiru. Can we fill up as it is? As a nakira? Cannot. Because at-tajiru is marifa. So you should put alif lam, then kabiru. Then here, ana talibun qadimun. I am a, qadim means old. Talibun, student. I am an old student. Can we put as it is or we have to include alif lam? Do we need to include alif lam? But these two we have to include alif lam. Here don't need to include alif lam. Why? The man'ud doesn't contain alif lam. So no need alif lam here. So ana talibun qadimun. Just write as it is. Okay? Just write. No need alif lam. Because talibun doesn't have alif lam. Jalasat talibu. The student. Jadidu. The new student sat. Khalfa Muhammadin. Behind the Muhammad. Okay, now. The question is. Do we need to include alif lam or not with jadidun? Yes, we have to include because the man'ut contains alif lam. So jadidun also should contain alif lam. Here alif lam, here alif lam, here don't need alif lam, here alif lam. Then come manil waladu tawilu. Who is the tall boy? Tall boy. Al waladu alif lam. So this one also should contains alif lam. Manil waladu tawilu. But put alif lam. The tall boy. Alladhi. Who. Kharajal anu minapasli. Who went out from now. From the classroom. Similarly. You can do. Next five. Same. You have to. Make sure whether you have to put the alif lam or not, then translate it into English also. Read, write, read. You can to take that one, very first one, ikra. You just read it. Ikra waktub. You have to read all the 10. It's good to read with meaning, English meaning. Writing, you can take number 6 to 10. Sorry, 11. Next, Iqra. Here we are practicing alladhi, relative pronoun. Alladhi, which is who, or which. If rational, then who? Irrational, which. الطالب الذي خرج من الفصل الآن من إندونيسيا. The student who went out from this classroom just now is from Indonesia. The student who went out from the classroom just now means Indonesia. Indonesia is a country name. Indonesia. 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 In Arabic. Indonesia. 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 الكتاب الذي على المكتب للمدرسين. The book. الكتاب الذي which is. Here who. Here which. Why? Rational, irrational. الكتاب الذي على المكتب للمدرسين. The book which is on the table is belongs to the teacher. للمدرسي. Belongs to the teacher. Third one. لمن هذا القلم الجميل. Whose is this beautiful pen? Beautiful pen. الذي على المكتب. Which is on the table. Which is on the table. Whose is this beautiful pen which is on the table? 4. Albaytul Kabiru, the big house. Albaytul Kabiru, the big house. Alladhi, which is fi dhalik kashari'i. Shari means street. Shari means street. The big house which is in that street is belongs to minister. Lil Waziri. Belongs to the minister. The big house which is in that street is belongs to the minister. Fifth. As-sarir alladhi fil ghurfati Khalidin maksurun. As-sariru. The bed. Alladhi which is fi ghurfatin bi ghurf fi ghurfati Khalidin. Mudaf mudaf ilayhi. Possessive phrase. Khalid's room. Ghurfa means room. The bed which is in the Khalid's room is maksurun, broken. Is maksurun, broken. The bed which is in the Khalid's room is broken. Okay. In this, we are just practicing the alladhi. Okay. Alladhi is a relative pronoun which will be translated as who or which. Who means for rational, which is for irrational things. So in this lesson, we have learned Na'at Manut. Baitun Jadidun, new house. In English, we will write the adjective first, then followed by the noun, right? In Arabic, the other way. New will come second. House will come first. This is first, this is second, right? But here is first, is second. Baitun Jadidun, new house. The baitun is, in grammatically, we called it as man'ud. Jadidun is na'atun, adjective. Okay. This is what we have learned in lesson 9. Inshallah, lesson 10, we will learn in next class. Jazakumullah khairan kathira. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.